Hey there, welcome back to another Ask Our Experts episode with me, your host, Ulysses. Today we'll continue with our topic about power over Ethernet and the different terms associated with PoE. Alan, there are many terms used to describe PoE. Could you help us understand what they all mean?
Thanks for that, Ulysses. You know, whenever you're in a certain technology, there's always a vernacular, there's always a jargon that you use. And a lot of people use PoE, PoE+, and PoE++. What these are shorthand terms for actually IEEE 802.3 standards. PoE itself stands for IEEE 802.3 AF standard, which can deliver up to 15 watts. PoE Plus refers to IEEE 802.3 AT standards, which can deliver up to 30 watts. And PoE Plus refers to IEEE 802.3 BT standards, which can deliver up to 90 watts. Now, within all of these groups, the higher group can deliver down to the lower group because PoE automatically classifies how much power is needed. And power is delivered over 100 meters. So that means if you're delivering power over an Ethernet cable that's 100 meters long, and you deliver 90 watts at the source, that means at the end of 100 meters, you're only going to get 71 watts. But that's how most in the industry refer to it, either through the standards or PoE, PoE+, and PoE++.
Thank you, Alan, for explaining the different types of PoE. It is interesting to know that PoE+ can deliver more power than PoE, and PoE++ can deliver even more power than PoE+. To our viewers, you can learn more about PoE and its different types in our helpful links in the description of this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. Bye for now.